Welcome back to Ucypher and Sport, Nice Superstars. After CSGO, the scores are Crusaders at 5 and Yakshas at 6. Crusaders have put up a great show for us today, but it's time for the last game, the decider, the spectacular game of DOTA 2.
Turn to ban. The dire get a ban. Is the radiant ban? Ten seconds. The dire get a ban. Seconds. Is the radiant ban? Ten seconds. Dire's turn to pick. Radiant's turn to pick. Lich.
Welcome back to Ucypher Season 1, ladies and gents. We're moving into round robin number 2 with Crusaders taking on Yakshas in one of their last few games of the tournament. Crusaders are going to be on the Radiant side, Yakshas on the Dire, and over on the casting desk, it's CloudX and Vivek. Vivek, your thoughts on this first pick, Earth Spirit, coming out from Crusaders?
So, I like the first pick, Earth Spirit. It's something Bakemon has played a lot. But the Crusaders, they're in a really hard place so far. I mean, normally we have a ritual of just updating you guys with the points in case you missed out on your quick look at the league table. But right now, the numbers don't make sense for the Crusaders. They have lost 18 out of their 19 single-player games so far, or is it 17 out of 18? They're 1-1 out of all their games in Tekken and Real Cricket.
I think you've driven the message across that their single-player strengths are pretty lacking right now.
But they made a phenomenal comeback in Counter-Strike.
Their Counter-Strike has been good. Their Dota has been lackluster. I was really expecting more of a whitewash coming out from Crusaders, because honestly, going into the tournament, post the drafting phase, I thought Crusaders had one of the stronger lineups, at least for Dota 2.
Yep.
Unfortunately, they failed to deliver. Now, I'm not sure if that's because of a lack of leadership in their ranks, or if it's because there's just too many conflicting opinions and egos within the roster. Because they're all very talented players.
Yeah.
It's just that they may have way too many opinions, and there's no one to streamline them into something productive. Mm-hmm. Yakshas, on the other hand, they've sort of rallied behind Akrid. They didn't start off so strong, but along the course of the tournament, they've proven that they are a force to be reckoned with. And rightly so, because as things stand, they're sitting on top of the table. They do have a fairly predictable playstyle, though. This Medusa has been one of their favorites. They love to run it with the Undying whenever they get the opportunity to do so. In this particular game, if the Undying is not banned, I'd be super surprised if Yakshas didn't pick it up. There's two strength heroes on the other side. Decay works fantastically versus them. They're melee heroes as well, so they're going to be clumped up around the tombstone. And of course, Medusa, one of those heroes that likes to have heroes coming in her face. I'm so sorry, I did not mean that as intended. Medusa, who likes heroes coming up to her face with the stone gaze basically turning them off.
What? Anyway, it's a good thing that these clips get heavily edited for television. But yeah, the Undying is definitely a pick worth considering. The Yakshas have banned out the Spectre. Now, I was wondering about the Undying. The thing is, in the past, Yakshas have had Punk play the Undying.
He's probably going to play the Lich though this time around.
Yeah, so I'm not sure if VP would be playing the Undying or something more like the Clockwork. Fortunately, the Crusaders have sort of caught up with VP's hero pool. They banned out both the Clockwork as well as the Slada, the Earthshaker being banned as well. And it's a good adjustment coming out from the Crusaders, They've but VP plays the Sand King.
Yeah, exactly. They've got the Sand King that could still be picked up. Most of the usual suspects have been taken out, like you said, but yeah, the Sand King is one of VP's go-to heroes. I'd like to see that coming out. We're yet to see a Vengeful Spirit pick up at Ucypher. I think we saw
Blue
one.
Blue Cog played.
Yeah, we saw one Venge that worked well for them. It was versus a Batrider, so there was all the more reason to pick it up. But I think Venge is one of those all-season four positions. You know, I don't think you really need a specific reason to pick her up, especially given the buffs to the way she works now. Upon death, she basically sends a mini-me to go beating up whoever killed her.
And anybody who dies in vicinity of the Vengeful Spirit gets a mini-me.
Really?
Yeah, for 7 seconds.
Okay then. I mean, why isn't Venge being picked up more often then? Crusaders, they'll go with the silencer. I'm not entirely sure what to make of this, to be honest, because on the one hand, it's pure damage, which honestly holds little to no value versus the Medusa. She's got the Mana Shield, which blocks all sources of damage.
Yeah.
And on the other hand, now they've got a Manta Style. They've got two Manta Style cores on the side of Yakshas, the Medusa and the Juggernaut. I'm not sure what that silencer pick was meant to do. It seems like it's just, you know, they're at a point where they... So, as sad as it is, Crusaders can't come first on the league table right now. That's just the way the points have stacked up against them. It's probably that point in the game where they're like, you know what, we're on the main stage, we're getting a fair bit of exposure on a new platform. Let's make the most of it, guys. Let's have some fun while we're here. What do you want to play? I want the silencer. And then, well, Darshan goes ahead and picks up the silencer for him. That's basically what's happening here by the looks of it. Yeah, that's exactly what's happening. Outside over a cup of tea, we spoke to Remstar and he mentioned that he wanted Weaver. And he was confident that if he gets Weaver, he wins the game. So Crusaders is just picking what each individual player prefers. This, honestly, this works in your pub games every now and then because your opponents are doing the same thing. But Yakshas have come into this one with a plan. Unfortunately, their plan doesn't hold any sort of lockdown, which is why the Weaver actually works out as a good pick.
Yeah.
Not to mention the Stampede and the Rolling Boulder for additional mobility versus the lack of lockdown.
I guess VP goes Sand King now.
Yeah, it seems like the obvious choice.
I'm still not a fan of Yakshas just picking up their cores so early on. I understand that the Medusa is ban-worthy. And if you have a high win rate with the Medusa, you pick it up.
What? Okay. I'm not a fan of this at all because...
It's greedy.
Where is he going to go?
So, what are we looking at? An offlane Medusa? A mid Juggernaut? No, a mid Meepo
so,
and a...
One of the primary reasons why this doesn't work in, well, a professional gaming scenario is because Meepo and Medusa are both possibly the most greedy cores in the game today. Yeah. Meepo needs a good early start, he needs the jungle for himself, and he needs to be able to split push and farm multiple camps at the same time. Where the hell does the Medusa farm in that scenario? And if Medusa is taking up whatever little farm is left up on the map, what's the Juggernaut left doing? Yakshas are... I don't know, I feel like this is a... Either this is a random pick or it's just... I don't know, someone dared him to pick the Meepo. But this is super risky.
I like to see the Crusaders just pick up something like the Pugna and try and end quick.
Ooh, that might hurt them actually.
Hurt the Crusaders?
It might. Because Pugna, let's face it, is not the best at dealing with the Meepo. Not entirely fantastic versus the Medusa either. Good versus the Juggernaut, but that's really the only value that Pugna
has. So they're looking for a mid laner that should be able to push. Actually, hold on. So Remstar is playing the Weaver. Remstar goes to the mid lane with the Weaver. So they're looking at a safe laner
not
that can...
Not necessarily. I mean, they could swap things up. Invincible is a decent middle laner.
They could swap things up. If they're looking for a safe lane core, I'd like the Chaos Knight. No.
For Crusaders, I'm honestly thinking the Invoker's the best pickup here. We know that Invincible plays a mean Invoker, and getting points into the Vex, maybe even going for an early Quas Vex build with the Invoker, even though it's super unconventional, might not be terrible. You'll basically delete the Medusa's Mana Shield and you'll have a way to control the team fights versus that Meepo. Okay. I think it's not a bad choice at all.
Yeah, but, I don't mind.
Look at Yaksha's draft here though. We talked about the lack of lockdown on their side and they've gone and overcompensated with the Meepo. That's four heroes with Earthbinds coming out. But honestly, I worry for them. Crusaders does have a lineup that can go hunting in the jungle early on. Earth Spirit is not too bad at that at all. Centaur, once he gets his Blink Dagger, could join the Earth Spirit. The two of them with the 1-2 punch combination could make a lot of beautiful things happen across the map. And just for good measure, if they do add that Invoker on top of all of this, you've got the Sunstrike for cleanup duty. Yakshas will go with the Disruptor. That's their answer to the Weaver's mobility, but this is a Bhelpuri of a draft, man. They've just thrown in random elements and they've come up with something that they call a strong lineup that I call utter garbage. Yakshas have... This is some poor drafting coming after them.
Yeah, I'm in agreement with you. I'm not seeing the synergy. Everybody wants to farm. I hope Crusaders pick a core that can help them push early on. Push early on, force them to fight, force an under-level Meepo and an under-level Juggernaut to fight. And what are they going to do?
Are we looking at an aggressive tri lane? No, that seems unlikely. Maybe a 2-1-2, that's possible. I like Crusaders going with the Invoker. I'm still not entirely convinced it's enough, but it's a lot. It could work. Especially if Bakemono manages to land his his Boulder Smashes this game.
Yeah.
I think the last time we saw an Earth Spirit, was it Bakemono himself that went rolling bouldering about the map and missing?
No, that was Blue Frog.
That was Blue Frog, right. But, I mean, the Earth Spirit has had mixed success over here. Usually he's successful when there's an additional lockdown in your 5 position. Unfortunately, here there isn't. All right, Vivek, quick predictions based on the draft and based on your understanding of these two teams.
I think Crusaders are going to win this.
So, looking at just the drafts, I'd be in agreement with you, but looking at past performances, Yakshas have managed to pull a rabbit out of the hat quite often. They do excel in the late game stage, and if they can get themselves to that late game stage, they win.
So, I have a question. I mean, it's... Yeah, I think I've answered my own question. So, Earthbind does cancel TPs.
I believe it's only the first Earthbind that cancels the TP. So... For example, if you're within Earthbind and you try and you're TPing out, you basically get away.
Okay.
But I'm not sure if they changed something to the routes or as of one of the latest
patches. There was a change to route, right? Certain routes don't cancel TPs and certain routes do.
If I'm not wrong, you can TP out of Earthbind.
Okay.
But I may be mistaken. These mechanics have gotten...
I mean, in that sense, the only lockdown is the Disruptor. The only source of cancelling TPs then is the Disruptor.
Oh yeah, that's true. You no longer have the mini stun on the chain frost either, so that's...
This is Remstar's game to shine. This is Invincible's game to shine. I mean, on paper, you could have asked for a better lane if you're the Invoker. I understand that the Meepo's going to farm, but you should be able to farm as well.
I don't know, man. I wouldn't be so sure about that. I mean, honestly, I feel like the Meepo does...
It boils down to skill, but the Invoker should be fine even then.
So the Invoker's going to farm, but he's not going to be able to dominate the Meepo.
He's not going to be able to dominate the Meepo.
A couple of levels in, what's the Meepo going to do? He simply walks up to the wave, double poofs, pushes it out, goes into the jungle, rinse and repeat. The way to deal with that is to actually have early points in the Alacrity, cold snap Alacrity and beat the hell out of one of those Meepos, disrupt his rhythm in a way that he has to send one back to the fountain, thus delaying his farm and growth. Invincible, I'm sure he's got this lockdown. I'm sure he's played versus Meepos on matchmaking multiple times. And if Pokemon rotates in, they can shut down the Meepo quite hard. But so far, we've seen some lackluster movements towards the mid lane, more so by Crusaders, which is why I'm not entirely confident that Invincible is going to win that matchup.
It's an offlane Juggernaut.
And now I've seen everything. Khalnayak on the offlane Jug. Is he actually going to be soloing here, or is VP going to be joining him? VP did start with the boots on that Disruptor. Meanwhile, on top lane, Darshan's gone ahead and started with the Stout Shield and an extra Mango for that regeneration. He's up against a Medusa, who's going to be supported by the Lich, I assume, and the Disruptor, perhaps. And check out what Crusaders are up to.
Yeah, they're prepping for Kelia. The Arcane Curse connects on both of them. Kalnag has the Blade Fury, but no boots. The lockdown is not there. Bakemono doesn't want to roll in just yet. I'm going to do some early damage, force out the first couple of tangos of the game. Remstar is actually giving chase. He is tagged by the Thunderstrike. He picks up the Bounty Rune. Kalnag with the Blade Fury. Remstar is Tsukuchi on cooldown for 3-2-1 second. Should be able to get out, and indeed he will. Kalnag now caught between the Silence and the Earth Spirit. There's the Sunstrike. An Invincible draws first blood. Remstar pops the healing salve, turns on a VP. VP senses that there's nothing to cancel TPs, but the damage is there, and Remstar scores another kill.
What's worse is SSK starts off with 4 bonus intelligence. Yeah. This is the best possible start that they could have gotten. They're actually running this safe lane, tri lane, and they were up against one of the most ridiculous tri lanes I've seen coming out on the Dire side. Kalnaya gets punished for it, so too does VP's Disruptor, and now they've just turned this into a straight up try versus try scenario after they've gotten a beating already.
Has Yaksha really pushed their luck with this draft? I mean, I understand that they have a lead, but this, I don't know, the word is just cocky in my opinion.
What's the game plan here, honestly? Because they don't have a lockdown to deal with that Weaver in the late stage either.
And Punk has put the point in a sacrifice. So he's literally offering nothing other than a couple of auto attacks.
Yeah, he's a walking human observer.
For now, there's not much he can do. And once SSK hits level 2, I'd like to see the Crusaders probably try and make another play.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I think it's in their best interest to just let VP get away from this lane. Top lane, it's Darshan on the center versus Akrid on the Medusa. Darshan did manage to steal away his Bounty Rune, by the way. And given that he started with the Stout Shield, he went ahead and picked up a Quelling Blade as well. He's just here to farm and do his own business. He really doesn't care that the Medusa's auto-attacking him. In fact, Akrid might just be taking more damage than he's dishing out after a while.
Mm-hmm. Nobody has picked up any magic sticks just yet in this try-on-try scenario. Kalnaya could do well to pick them up. The wave pushes in. SSK too preoccupied with just leeching EXP, not handling the equilibrium very well. Appa farming comfortably in the mid lane, as a Meepo rightly should.
He's gotten practically every creep in the lane. He's at 12 and 1 right now, and he's up to level 3. Invincible is forced to last hit under his own tower. Meepo's winning this lane hands down, and unfortunately, Bakemono can't move to that lane because he's preoccupied with the try versus try. If Crusaders aren't going to get anything done with their safe lane, try lane, I think Bakemono just should consider getting the hell out of here.
Yeah,
and in fact, that's what he's doing. Appa could be in trouble here.
Bakemono, the Earthbinds are there. Rolling Boulder. Boulder smash as well, but Invincible's dropping low. He pops the Fairy Fire. One Meepo left upon him, the other retreating. And now Appa needs to be careful. The Sunstrike is available.
No, it isn't. He doesn't have the mana for it.
Okay, he committed to the Fort Spirit.
Huh. Yeah, that seemed like a bit of a panic play coming out from Invincible. He just popped a Ford Spirit on his way out. If anything, it might have been better simply turn around with a Cold Snap, but I'm not sure he had the mana for the Invoke and the Cold Snap. Either way, the aggression has been thwarted. Appa will be sent all the way back to the base. He does have a TP, so he'll be able to join the middle lane quickly enough. And, well, with the CS advantage, he did pull ahead in terms of levels as well. But in bottom lane, SSK taking quite a beating, but they're going to return the favor here with Bakemono going on the wide ball, but he gets the Boulder Smash. The Sunstrike doesn't quite connect, but they'll get the kill nonetheless. SSK now being chased down by the Juggernaut. Khalnayak will slice him to bits, but it ends up being a 1-for-1 with Silencer walking away with some intelligence under his pocket.
Yep. SSK gets intelligence and Remstar surging for more. It's 2 points in the Sukuchis, so that does hurt the Disruptor a fair bit. But yeah, in the end, he's been forced to back out. Bakemono, his Boulder Smash not being used there.
Yeah, but every second that the Earth Spirit spends in the bottom lane is a second that Appa can farm confidently on this middle lane, pushing the wave consistently, just making space and time for him to go for the runes and go for the neutral creeps.
Have you noticed that Darshan is pretty much winning the CS in the top lane?
He's basically dominating that Medusa. And in a 1v1 with a Centaur that's got a Mango and a Ring of Health to regenerate, what is Akrid expected to do here? Not like Darshan really needs any mana, so he can take a Mystic Snake to the face and be hunky-dory. Darshan's also put a second point into the return, so it's less of an incentive for Akrid to poke him. And it's not like Medusa has, you know, the best base damage in this game. Centaur's at 73, she's sitting at 57. Centaur can practically outlast hit her, out deny her. And once again, it's cycling back to the fact that this lineup is so stupidly greedy on the side of Yakshas. Crusaders have spotted it and are punishing it.
Yep.
Now, this is one of the most obvious things that Meepo could have done. With the creep wave sitting next to his own tower, he's gone jungling.
Yeah.
He hasn't respected the fact that Bakemono and SSK
are
missing.
Bakemono needs to just connect. It's an easy Boulder Smash. He's not going to miss this. Yep. Yeah. Arcane Curse, last word. The Sunstrike is going to miss.
The Shrine
comes online exactly at the 5-minute mark. That's when Bakemono decided to move in. And he's going to be punished. He doesn't have a TP, so there's no way he gets out. And Appa with the quick poof farms a couple of neutral creeps and also an Earth Spirit.
That works out exceedingly well for Appa.
Yeah.
I mean, if the greed, they're just fueling his greed instead of punishing it by going in like that. I'm not certain why Bakemono chose not to boulder in the first place. He chose to get a Boulder Smash off and
top
then
lane,
no in,
Stampede,
top.
Last word, Arcane Curse as well. There's the Sunstrike, but Bakemono, what have you done? You single-handedly bought Akrid time. but the time simply not enough as Darshan cleans up. Quick cast wars of the first order.
I'm not sure if that was quick cast or just misclicking there, Bakemono. That could have been his teammates getting up and flaming him on the stage right there, honestly. But Darshan, he's got the Tranquil Boots queued up in addition to that Ring of Health that he's already finished in. So we should see him sitting extremely comfortably on this lane. He does have the Shrine to work with too, so he's not going to need a base trip. Meanwhile, Appa, he picked up a Haste Rune, but he's choosing not to go fighting with it. Instead, just going back into the jungle, accelerating his farm towards that Blink Dagger. It is a Blink Rush Meepo, so we should see this as a space creation Meepo as opposed to one of those farming greedy Meepos. And that honestly could be the way that it works for them. Instead of going back and farming consistently, Appa just goes around the map killing and opening up space on the map for the Medusa.
Bakemono and SSK still hanging around the top lane. They want revenge on Appa after what he did to them in their own jungle, but VP is here. VP tagged with the last word, a Mystic Snake as well too. Man, Boulder Smash, Rolling Boulder aggressively by Bakemono. Now SSK gets out and Bakemono is all by himself. VP pops the stick charges, he's gonna be fine, and Appa scores another kill in the jungle.
The whole Happy family just came in because of that obvious rotation again from the Earth Spirit and the Silencer. There was a Dire Observer Ward just watching the two of them over there, chilling next to the trees. They TP into the Shrines, they TP into the Tier 1, and they make that gank look stupidly easy. Appa claims the kill for it and shoots right back up onto the net worth shards. Yakshas have picked such a greedy lineup and Crusaders are unable to punish us. Their early game should not have been this bad.
This is this absolute misstep on the part of the Crusaders and how they're playing this early game. Remstar is also losing the safe lane. Meepo's getting kills in the jungle. Kalag is making an offlane Juggernaut work. This isn't good news for the Crusaders.
Yeah, I mean, in theory, I just don't know what the hell Yakshas' draft was supposed to do in the early game, but they've used the Meepo as bait next to the Shrines and gotten two kills for him because of it.
Yeah.
That the risk of losing the early game has essentially been mitigated now, and as we move into the mid-game stage, it's going to boil down to who's got the higher levels and who's got more items sitting under their belt. Meepo, the clear winner in this early game stage, is going to come out with a Blink Dagger in just about 10 to 11 minutes. Invoker's been farming for the most part. The only thing he's going to have for all that net worth to show is a Midas, and that's not going to add to his firepower.
Darshan, he's got the Hood complete, needs to pick up his own Blink soon enough. That Hood won't keep him alive for too long versus Appa, as well as the rest of the Yakshas.
I mean, it's going to help versus most of them, so it's actually the best item choice he could have gone for here. Bottom lane, Remstar, how's he looking in terms of farm? He's sitting at 18 CS. Wow, okay, he's been shut down.
I don't even know how that happens.
Khalnayak is at 39 in a tri-lane that was being pressured quite heavily, and then because Bakemono and Co. went hunting and didn't find anything on the back of that, they essentially lost all three lanes.
Yeah.
Appa, his Blink Dagger is basically online for all intents and purposes now.
I like the idea of ganking the Meepo. The problem is the Sunstrike didn't connect. They fought when the Shrine was active right next to the Shrine. The advantage of the new Shrine position is that actually contesting an offlaner or a mid laner falls back into the jungle. I mean, when you go to contest them, the problem is that reinforcements are nearby. And just a Disruptor who was level 2 or level 3 TPing in was more than enough for Appa to turn the fight around.
Invincible is being super inefficient, by the way. He chose not to go back to his lane when there was a creep wave under his tower. Instead, just farming up a neutral camp and then running back to the fountain. This usually works when you're looking to go hunting with the Invoker, but at this point, I don't think hunting should be on his cards. He's just going to TP back to the middle lane now. He basically went back for a mana
bottom lane, Bakemono. He's cut out VP and Punk in the trees. The geomagnetic grip is there, but the rolling boulder backwards. Remstar tanks an Omni Slash. He's caught in the kinetic field, and it seemed as if they had vision of him. For indeed, there was a sentry in the trees. Kalnag just going to push him back with the Blade Fury, but the boulder smash ensures a kill on a VP and Punk in a lot of trouble. The swarm upon him. Darshan starts out with a hoof stomp. It's a double kill for Bakemono, and the rolling boulder connects on Khalnag, who says thank you very much and just chops down the Earth Spirit. The arcane curse upon Khalnag. Darshan does have the double edge coming off cooldown. Khalnag turned for the bounty rune, and that was the death of him. Meanwhile, Appa scores a solo kill in the Invoker with that blink dagger just revealed.
Just when you thought that things were going in favor of the Crusaders, they end up giving up a solo kill on the middle lane. They've started the Meepo snowball and it's showing no signs of stopping because on the top lane, yeah. Bakemono could be the next casualty, but Appa almost entirely whiffs his spells there. But it doesn't matter because the Geostrike slow does kick in and they finish the job. Meepo, he's gotten active now. He's going to make them pay for giving him all that free space. The only thing that Crusaders have going for them is that SSK has played some good DOTA. I mean, he's just been in the right place at the right time. He's gotten himself level 6 with that Tomb of Experience that's been consumed now. And he's also got himself 12 Stolen Intelligence. So he packs quite a punch for a measly 5 position support.
Yeah, but I don't know. A silencer with a good early game. How game-changing can that be?
Remstar, he's had no joy whatsoever. He's still missing last hits on the bottom lane. Up top though, Meepo's back in business once again, but Meepo's the one that's being jumped upon. The global silence is committed and Meepo will die. Now Darshan with the hood buffing him up continues to move forward. VP's just been annihilated there.
Yeah,
with the double edge coming through
it.
As well.
Akrit pops the stone gaze. He's looking to TP out. Can they cancel the TP? Do they even know?
Why is Invincible invisible?
Just invincible things. I mean, okay, now Goshpa gives you movement speed when you have points in Vex, but not sure what that was about.
I think he's panicking a bit here. He did throw out a Sunstrike somewhere.
Yeah,
that
was done. Punk was being gone upon by the Weaver and Invincible does manage to bring down the Lich.
All right, Crusaders finding a bit of momentum going their way. Getting that kill on the Meepo and then shortly after on the Lich, losing nothing in the bargain for it. Maybe they can turn this into a bit of momentum for themselves again now. Maybe take a tier 1 tower on the back of it. But Appa means business and Appa is back. They've used the Dire scan as well. Unfortunately, Appa's not going to be able to find anyone because that was going to be... Well, that scan only tagged a retreating Darshan. Khalnayak. He's got himself the Omni Slash again, but Remstar has that time lapse on the bottom lane, so there's no point in trying for the solo kill. Although Khalnayak could still bully the hell out of Weaver in the laning stage. All he's got to do is run up to him with the phase boots and get a couple of auto attacks off. Even if he's got a sentry ward down there, life would get significantly easier for him. Up top, Darshan with the hood and the blink dagger now complete. I'm a little surprised that we're not seeing a smoke being popped on the side of Crusaders with that blink pickup. He just walked into the lane, showed the blink dagger, and now he's going elsewhere.
Yeah, he's moving to the mid lane. He sees Appa by himself. If he connects the hoosh thumb,
it's
Bakemono...
unlikely though, because even if they smoke now, the blink has been revealed. So they know what to look for. They know to be careful.
Okay, so they're going to smoke. Invincible joins them. Can they find the rest of the Yakshas with their pants down? SSK leading the charge, Invis rune upon him, drops an Observer. Appa going for the run, trying to poof away, but Darshan right on top of him, the Stampede committed, the Boulder Smash as well, Bakemono holding on to the Magnetize, doesn't commit it, and SSK with the help of the Deafening Blast scores the kill. They're moving towards Khalnag. Khalnag nearest tier 1, doesn't have a TP. Can Darshan go in once more? Bakemono, is he going to commit? Looks like he's not.
Yeah, minimal commitment coming out there from Crusaders. They get the kill quick and clean. No global silence expended, no magnetize expended. And Silencer walks away with a bit more intelligence upon himself. They're going to move bottom and they should get this tier 1 tower. But it's going to come at the cost of their own tier 1 on the top lane. Which should be a bit more money going into Akrit's pocket.
Well, actually that tier 1 is already gone down and... Maybe if the Yakshas want to come back to defend, they can. They glimpsed back Darshan, they caught him in the kinetic field. Khalnag has the Omni Slash, decides to go with the Blade Fury. Darshan did pop that quick hood, but here comes Akrit. Mystic Snake and that last crit from Khalnag will secure the kill upon Darshan. So they get the tier 1, but they give away a killing spree to the offlane Juggernaut, who at the 15-minute mark has more net worth than the Weaver.
Mid, There's a global silencescape, Invincible alive, but the geostrike slows are just stacking up, and Invincible will die nonetheless. Appa, he doesn't have a meeple. Well, actually, did he have a clone somewhere else to get out of? No, actually, all three clones are in the middle lane. He's still fighting his way through Bakemono. He micros one meeple away to the side and keeps him alive, gets himself a double, but ends up losing his life to Remstar. That's still totally worth it for Appa, man. He just walks in, takes down two by himself, and finally goes down while the rest of his team takes a tier one on the bottom lane.
Yeah. I think Appa's made space. He's killed Invincible, he's killed Bakemono, he's gotten the tier 1 at mid, and at the back of this, the Yakshas are picking up another tier 1 tower. So, the problem...
Why is the lineup that's supposed to be turtling, pushing and taking all tier 1s within the first 16 minutes of the game? This game makes no sense to me anymore.
I think for the Yakshas, this game is more of a statement than anything else. I don't know what Darshan is thinking. The Mystic Snake bounces and it hurts. Kalan goes in with the Omni Slash, does have the Blade Fury, but he forces out a Stampede and a quick reaction from Darshan. Now, Darshan could look to go back in. He has the Blink of cooldown, but VP with the Thunderstrike immediately disabling it. Glimpsing back Darshan, the Kinetic Field is second to late. But Darshan might have to make a base trip or a trip to the Shrine. Unfortunately, the Shrine's not
I mean,
up.
I'd love to know what the statement there was.
I'll tell you what the statement is for the Yakshas. Why are they... I mean, what I'd like to believe is... what my read of this game is... that the Yakshas want to show that there's a lot of depth to their draft, that they can play these curveball heroes, and they want teams to fear this, and they want teams to do silly things like banning out Meepo. I think that's about it for the Yakshas.
I don't know, man.
They want to show that they have depth. They want to show that they're more than the Medusa and the Undyne.
I honestly don't think anyone's going to ban a Meepo because of this. You simply just draft around him and deal with it. Kalnaya, good Blade Fury there, just in the nick of time.
Darshan glimpsed back. Here comes Remstar trying to TP in. The Boulder Smash connects enacted. You got the Geomagnetic Grip to follow it up. The Magnetize thrown in as well. The healing was on the floor. No one's paying attention. You got the Sunstrike. Good hoop stomp from Darshan. They're focusing down Acrid and they'll get him. Kalnayak with that Yasha and with a little bit of health from Punk gets the return kill while Invincible somehow snipes off VP. Remstar giving chase. Punk just going to TP out of his face. But the Tornado's there. The Meatball committed. Overcommitment at its finest and now nothing. Nothing to cancel Kalnag's TP.
So the problem with this, with Crusader getting all these kills and not getting the Meepo is that he just goes elsewhere and continues to farm at maximum speed. So even though his team was busy on the bottom lane and everyone on the side of Crusaders were busy doing something there, Appa still wins the net worth war over there.
Yep. He's going to even inch closer and closer to his sheep stick, after which... I don't know. I don't know how you survive if you're the Weaver who's nowhere close to a Lincoln Sphere.
SSK, he's been tagged and there's a Meepo in the vicinity. The glimpse could work against him here. The glimpse is there, but it's in a different direction. Doesn't really matter. The blinks with the poops. Appa gets a freebie and goes back to farming.
Bakemono could trail Appa if he wants to.
Darshan's here as well.
On the other side of the map. Invincible scores a solo skill.
He sunstrikes the disruptor and gets that kill by himself, but Bakemono still tailing Appa here. Unfortunately, Darshan has given up on this.
Yeah.
Just a little longer is what Appa's saying right now. He wants to get that Scythe of Vice. Has the Mystic Staff, just needs the Void Stone to finish it up.
I think Bakemono spotted this out and he's trying to bring in reinforcements. Now, Remstar's Tsukuchi through and the Geomagnetic Grip as well as the Boulder Smash on top of Appa. Magnetize, Hoof Stomp, Sunstrike as well. It's a matter of who gets the kill amongst the Crusaders. And it's Darshan.
They threw everything at him.
They're chasing for Punk. Punk TP'd in. Punk's go-to answer when he needs to survive is to TP out. Remstar sees this as an opportunity, jumps up on Punk, gets the kill. But the Static Storm holds Remstar in place. Remstar does have the time-lapse still. He's been glimpsed back, wants to pop the time-lapse, but VP solo kills a Weaver.
Now that's Kalnayak
with...
Kalnayak's got 2 points in the Omni Slash. If he catches Bakemono here, he'll get the kill by himself, no doubt.
Yeah, you've got TPs coming in. The glimpse is on cooldown, but Kalnayak just giving chase. You gotta get that Boulder Smash off. It's gonna buy time, but the glimpse is there. VP pulls back Bakemono, who's stationary and held in place. That's not the Stone Gaze, folks. That's AFK at its finest.
That's...
He gave up. He gave up. I mean, what could he do? He had no mana, no way of getting out.
Well then. Now I've seen everything. Solo kill by the Disruptor on the Weaver. Casual kitchen sink thrown on the Meepo's head to get that kill. And then severe overextension coming out by Bakemono and the rest, who then chose to run through a shrine.
The only piece of good news for the Crusaders is that Invincible is having a good game. He's been connecting some of the Sunstrikes, he's sitting atop the network charts. But is an Invoker going to be enough?
Is the key question here, really. I mean, yeah, I think the Invoker was a fantastic pick, and now with his extra points coming out in the Vex, he is going to be able to get that Mana Shield taken apart quite efficiently as well. Problem is, they're still lacking that control for the Meepo. The only thing they've got going for them is that Boulder Smash that Bakemono seems to be doing a good job with the play.
Absolute white ball there. The Tornado missed. I'm not sure what Invincible was attempting, but he's actually at least made up make a base trip with a couple of those Meepos.
He's also hoping to get that Sunstrike off on one of those Meepos, but kind of whiffs. That'll be a base trip for Appa and a bunch of Invincible skills on cooldown. Kalnayak's been slowed down quite a bit though. He's just stuck with the Yasha and the phase boots. I mean, what more can you expect from an offlane Juggernaut, really?
Mm-hmm.
Akrid hasn't had the ideal amount of farm either though.
Yeah. Both safe laners haven't done too well in the
rush
farm.
Rush the Hurricane Pike instead of a Manta versus the Silencer.
I don't know. I think you'd get the Manta immediate. Darshan goes in, he's right on top of VP. This could be VP dropping the Static Storm. Yes, it is, but the kinetic feels slightly off. Darshan just hanging to the side, the hood, bang him time. He pops the Stampede and ends up falling. No Sunstrike this time around to find a kill in response. Akrid and Kalnayak both TP to the mid lane.
Well, they get that kill without any real loss of life on their own side. VP just overestimating his tankiness with a hood and a plate, man. That still doesn't give you a license to go into the tier 2 tower by yourself.
Just bad decision making coming up from Darshan. I mean, he has a blink, he wants to use it, but you're diving a tier 2 with an Earth Spirit and a Silencer to back you up.
Remstar, going for that tier 1 on the top lane now. Wants to make sure that they get some sort of map advantage with this tower going down, but Yakshas, they're in position to contest this. They do have the Omni Slash still available, but do they have detection? Appa's got the Scythe of Vice, so if he jumps in here and catches Remstar first, things could go horribly south.
Kalnayak,
he pops the dust, he gets silences up. There is the Magnetize thrown on the floor, along with the Global Silence as well. The fight is split up. Here comes the Tornado, the EMP, the Meteor. It's all only on Akrid, who sticks up once again. Appa throws out those Earth Pines, but can't quite find anyone. Well, Remstar's been caught with it now on the tail end of things. He does use that time lapse, but the Hex is there. And with that, his death has been secured. Meanwhile, Punk is going to take down to the last word. Darshan comes in with some support here. Pops the Stampede, moves towards the east side, gets the hell out of there. The Sunstrike, not going to connect on anyone for a kill. While SSK tries to TP out, he gets away successfully as well.
Earthbind Zone cancel TPs. Much like a Rod of Aetos.
Meepo.
So that's a 2-for-1 trade in favor of Crusaders. They end up losing the Weaver, which is quite costly in itself. But Meepo survives, Medusa survives.
So Invincible's approach to that fight was very interesting. He, I mean, just dropped 3 spells, then saw the Juggernaut run straight at him, popped the Ghostwalk and TP'd up.
We'll start, then we can take the question.
Yeah, just take
one
it.
By one.
He's going for the Link in sphere next, so no mobility items at all. No Blink Dagger,
I think
no
Blink.
I'm not against the Yule Scepter either this game, to deal with the Glimpse, to deal with the Meepo poofs. But yeah, you need the Linkins versus that Scythe of Vice. I can get behind it.
Earthbind.
Meanwhile, Akrid picks up a Yasha, so the Manta style does seem to be his item of choice. While SSK, he'll continue to open up some space on the map for his teammates by dewarding near the rush pit. You gotta remember that Yakshas has a really good lineup at taking down Roshan, even in this 25 minute mark. With the Meepo and the Juggernaut healing ward, Rosh will drop quickly and they won't lose too much life while doing it.
Basically, he has a power.
I like that Kalnayak chose to go for the Manta style first though. That is absolutely necessary.
Yeah.
And what level does he start making? Second level.
I mean, now the Global Silence doesn't affect it. Yeah. The Global Silence is not going to save you from an Omni Slash.
From third level,
and instant smoke coming up from the Yakshas. 24 minutes in, they're still not working with a clear network lead, but they've got the double damage rune upon Akrid, the Manta spell upon Kalnayak,
and the Shadow Blade on Appa
as well. Appa with the Shadow Blade, like you mentioned. Scythe of Vice to go along with it. VP trying to get some vision. It seems as if Darshan and the boys have a sense of what's going on. They're just falling back to their tier 3s. Time and time again, teams, despite drafting poorly, read the map in the most amazing of ways.
Yeah, I'm after not sure how they manage this every time, to be honest.
And now they're smoked up. Remstar had the alacrity upon him. Bakemono is leading the charge.
After that exciting game of CS:GO, now Dota 2 is
now
underway.
If he ever commits, the Cyclone could be dropped straight on top of him. But Darshan with the Stampede means they want to go in. They've jumped in on VP, the Global Sense, the second delay. Bakemono on Punk with the Magnetized Invincible pounding away. They get that kill. Darshan, Lotus up upon him, trying to make a retreat. Here's the Tornado. It's controlling accuracy. EMP on the floor. Ice Wall as well, but there's the Hurricane paying dividends. One man bolder smash. Bakemono jumps in. It's bouncing away an invincible, and with the help coming in from Apple, he gets the kill. Acted brought down by Remstar. Darshan goes in with a hoof stomp. They want VP, but Darshan will not get the kill. Appa scores a triple, and Remstar running back with the swarm.
He's a very difficult hero play.
That's going to be Roshan for them as well. They don't have the healing ward, but they've got 17 ward.
Oh, they've got detection. Remstar goes in for the kill, but Appa's got his back.
I don't know what Remstar was thinking. Going back into that fight over there, knowing that there have to be sentries in the vicinity. Just getting greedy and going for a kill on VP's disruptor. Absolutely silly stuff coming out of him. Khalnayak could die if Roshan decides to slam now, by the way.
Appa needs to be careful as well.
There it is, the slam from Roshan. The Aegis picked up by Appa. And now they got themselves a fresh Lizon live. I am super disappointed with Crusaders. I don't think the Yakshas have done anything exemplary here. I mean, sure, they played a good line. They played well. Their draft wasn't fantastic, but Appa's done a good job so far. But this is more on a fallacy on the part of Crusaders. They should have won the early game a lot more convincingly. Instead, they messed things up by running a seriously weak defensive tri-lane. And when they chose to run the tri-lane, and when it started working with SSK getting a lead, they sent Bakemono on SSK on a wild goose chase in the jungle, without smokes, and with some very crucial micro-level decision-making that went horribly wrong for them.
Meepo, who is playing for the Yakshas today, is an agility hero. Khalnayak. And his last power, ultimate power, is
I'm disappointed as well, man.
What happens is that hero Meepo...
I don't know, back in the day when...
Which means that now you have two heroes to attack one hero.
I looked up to Remstar.
Okay, there's one disadvantage.
I just realized that I was looking at Remstar to roast him with glasses
in. If you kill one Meepo,
been extremely meddling in this game.
That level, as in when you level up, you can
getting
make up
the defusal blade.
So it's
not too. I don't know.
I mean, so as in when you level up, you can make up to
Crusaders.
Four
the vibe I'm getting from Crusaders is that they're a broken team right now.
Yeah.
They're clearly upset that they can't make it to the top spot, which was every team's objective.
And if you
it's almost as if they've given up hope about whatever other positions they're reaching now.
That's insane, but isn't it difficult to handle
Remstar's
five
picked up the defusal. This is going to let him run down Punk and VP, but Punk and VP just see that he has nothing to keep him alive. No layer of defense, just turn upon the Weaver and bring him down themselves.
There's no Lincolns on the Weaver, which means Meepo just sets its sights on him and runs at him.
Yeah, and a couple of Ghost Scepters, and Remstar's going to be practically useless this game.
You also got to remember that Meepo picked up the Eagle Song, so he's got himself the extra agility, which essentially gives you armor as well. Unless they change something to the stats. No, it does give you armor. So.
It gives you a movement speed perk.
You can just kill them by.
Am I right?
Spell.
Yeah. Yep.
So he's doing that you incredibly armor. In the game. He's already got few kills with it.
Anyway.
So Crusaders Yakshas do they have late-game heroes or early-game heroes?
Crusaders, you know, every time they're playing Dota, they're
going
for the early game heroes.
Pushing up the top lane.
Right
they've got Aegis. They've got the advantage.
Farmed a lot.
But it's going to take another couple of deaths on Roshan before this game ends. Like the past couple of games on Ucypher have been in any indication. As to how teams like to play.
We talked about how Yakshas were the stronger team in the late game. They proved themselves to be the stronger team in heck even the early game and the mid game as well. And now the late game is entirely theirs. I don't see any way for anyone on the side of Crusaders to contest this. Appa's been pinged out desperately. They've got a sentry and an observer ward watching his invisible shenanigans. But he has an Aegis. What can they really do about this Meepo when he jumps in and finishes off a silencer first?
You can't just converge on
it. And that's how an aggressive.
The only ones with buyback are Invincible, Centaur War Runner, so and
Lich,
the Medusa.
Juggernaut.
Invincible's picked up
and,
Lincoln,
who
but
the Disruptor.
I don't know.
Disruptor. So they send Lich.
Well,
Disruptor.
They'll go for the
so
other tier 2
Lich,
tower if I'm not
Juggernaut
mistaken.
And Disruptor. Three heroes to target Weaver and whoever's
supporting
him.
If you're the Crusaders,
him.
This
so that
is when
you
want to hopefully
they make sure he doesn't
pick
make
up.
Any gold off that.
Walking out
and
though.
The thing,
he's
exactly, and the thing that helps the captain
accurate
the
he's
most
got his whole team
he's playing Medusa. So they've sent him alone in the top lane
as a range attack.
Yeah, I'm
against,
a little
like said,
unsure about why Yakshas aren't going for the jugular here. Are they waiting for any big
I think they're going for the
agility
last
hero with range
tier two.
Has more damage.
Oh, it's also the Manta style on the Medusa that was spending.
I'm not sure what the Crusaders are doing themselves.
I mean, he knows he's
there on an expedition.
Today he'll be
hoping to find, like, I don't know, a random radiance dropped on the floor or something that they can pick up and come back into this game. They pick, but on the other side, though, Yakshas have that Manta for Accurate, so another hero no longer susceptible to the global silence. They picked up the Eth Blade for the Meepo, if I'm not wrong, so he's got himself an absurd amount of damage.
Crusaders are just giving up. I don't know if they're giving up or what it is. Appa's going in, needs to be careful. So the rest of Yakshas are pushing out the tier 2. Let's take a look at who doesn't have TPs. Okay, everyone has TPs, so they're going to fall back. The tier 3 under siege, Kalnag making quick work of it. He's got the Manta style as well as the Diffuser. If I drop down net worth, I'm pretty sure he's above the Weaver, and yes, he is.
What are they doing? They're just giving up a tier 3 for free here.
I mean, this is confusing now.
For them, right now, winning is important.
The Yakshas came into high ground with the mindset that we might have to Roshan once. Stomp. Dashan goes in, good two-man stomp, Helnack eliminated, Tornado, EMP and Medusa, that's a good start. Good global silence as well, but as this time comes, there's the Chain Frost, pushing them back. Dashan's still running in, he's got the Lotus Orb, he's keeping VP and Acrid busy. But look at that, Appa jumps up on Remstar. That's the hero they didn't have lockdown for, and they've dealt with the Weaver. Appa's dropping low, Dashan dropping lower, they've got the magnetized, but how does Makimono do it? Appa, one of his clones has dropped incredibly low, and Remstar with the buyback secures the kill. Invincible hoping to cancel TPs, Punk barely falling to that magnetize, and they hold on to their high ground.
What happened to Appa there though? He ended up dying twice. Remstar bought back,
so
went
Appa
in and
killed
Appa.
Remstar, and I don't know how they killed Appa twice. I saw that killed Appa once.
So Remstar actually bought back and got the kill on Appa on the way back.
Yeah.
But that's three dead on the side of Yakshas. That's a slight recovery coming out from Crusaders. The basic tenets of Ucypher again remain in place. Nobody knows how to end the game.
So
they go on the high ground, they get a tier 3 and they essentially get team wiped.
Yeah, Kalnag dying like that really cost them. That was Kalnag dying without getting any spell off.
Awkward as hell that Kalnag got caught with a Hoofstomp when Blade Fury has no cast point and Hoofstomp has one. Slow reactions from Kalnag there. Wonder if the fight would have been significantly different though, if the Juggernaut was alive.
I mean, now there's smoke. If the Crusaders were looking at the mid lane, they might have caught the tail end of that smoke animation. Remstar's farming away. He's going towards a BKB.
What can a... Can the Disruptor...
It's going to help versus the Disruptor, but Earthbend still goes through BKB, right?
Oh, Remstar. There we go.
Remstar trouble. Static Storm this time whiffs. The Glimpse and Remstar back. And Remstar is thanking his stars.
I feel like VP hasn't played enough of Disruptor to know what the duration is between throwing down that glimpse.
Yeah. I think it's 3 seconds where you were, right? 4 seconds.
Invoker. He did pick up a Blink Dagger after that Aghanim's and the Lincoln Sphere. He's going for the BKB next. Just a severe amount of defense coming out of him, but none of that is going to help him in the face of Appa just right-clicking him away.
So, the last gank should give the Crusaders a lot of confidence. Just goes to show how severely they're lacking in the lockdown department. I mean, the kills that they gave away in the early game, if they take a look at the replay, they'll be hitting themselves on the head. Because it's actually immensely difficult for them to deal with the Weaver. Anyway, they're smoked up. Now, if they die, the game could possibly come to an end for them. Dashan without buyback. I mean, Dashan the only one on the side of the Crusaders with buyback. Are they comfortable moving up their own high ground? SSK's gone up there. I'm not sure what they're doing with this one. They're moving to the other end of the map. A lack of communication, a lack of coordination, but a kill on Appa could be you. Dashan needs to go in. Hoofstomp onto two of the Meepos. The Sunstrike is there. Global Silence committed. Deafening Blast, Meteor, they want everything they can to get this Meepo, and they will.
He doesn't have a buyback. He is dead for 98 seconds. They blew everything on him, so it may not be possible for them to keep going forward, but if they find another stray pickoff here, they definitely could. Crusaders severely committing to that fight, though. It may come back to hurt them now. However, with the tankiness that Darshan has and the fair bit of damage that Remstar has, they could definitely do some chip damage on the tier 3. It's already down to about a half HP. And Akrid, unfortunately, isn't packing quite a punch. He's chosen to go for the tanky build. Post the Manta, he's going for the Skadi.
If nothing else, they should welcome get the back top to here too, but this is even better. They're going to get Roshan.
Oh wow, he respawned. Crusaders are right back into this one.
At the first match victory ever, they are going
that net worth graph, it's being slowly tilted back in their favor. You can see the graph reaching the break-even point once again. And Rosh. Looks like he's going to go down uncontested here. Akrid is in the vicinity, but without a meeper for 40 seconds, they have no hope of contesting. Remstar claims an Aegis and Invincible claims the cheese.
Crusaders are going hard at the Yakshas, but I would still want to ask you about...
Invincible. He got BP as well on the bottom lane. His TP's been cancelled. Now he's going to get brought down. Another 50 seconds without a hero on the side of the Yakshas. Crusaders are slowly but surely finding their way back into this one.
Now's when they need to be able to get
for about 5-6 seconds.
Are they holding on to any wards?
Hero can't do anything.
Getting some vision down ASAP would be nice.
They have another
For a few seconds, yes. He can't do anything.
Nope. I think at this point, even with the Aegis, you just slow down with Crusaders. Get that BKB at Remstar and then go into the next fight. But what I'm worried about is that Medusa who's getting huge. The Skadi's going to make her unkillable. Invoker's going to have to commit an EMP upon her, and if she manages to force staff away from it,
so there's more damage.
Things get extremely hard in the fight for the entirety of Crusaders. Darshan, he's been on point with most of his initiation so far now. But how long can he keep this up?
At the first match victory, they're going hard at it. CSGO jeet chuke hai, Dota jeetne ka bhi chance hai.
SSK.
Currently, they've lost some team battles.
He's done his job. No real complaints for him. He's had 19 assists with the silencer, by the way. That is phenomenal.
Invoker has farmed a lot. He's made a boots of travel, basically.
26 stolen intelligence as well.
And then you can teleport.
Basically, gone about putting the dunce cap on everyone on the side of the dial.
And also, he's created a linking spear, which avoids, you know, if any other hero casts a spell on you, it won't give you any damage for a certain period.
No, like you mentioned, Remstar's BKB could possibly be worth waiting for.
Spell on you, the initial spell is blocked.
Considering that neither Punk nor BP have...
But it seems that Crusaders can't keep in defense. They're just grouping up on the top side to keep going for this. They've got a BKB on the Invoker. They've also got a cheese upon him, so... Why the hell not?
Well, the match is still left. Let's find out if Remstar and the Crusaders get their first.
Sphere thrown upon Remstar. They're going to trigger the Lincoln Sphere as well.
Problem is Apps is split pushing the bottom lane.
Well, the game
Appa,
is still...
not Apps.
My bad. Appa is split pushing the bottom lane. Apologies.
Well, the game they is still left. Let's find out Akrid if Remstar
is just running in. Darshan turns around with the Hoonstop. An ice wall upon Akrid. He's got to force stop quickly. Is the EMP going to connect? Yes, it is. It's a lot of mana taken away.
Not to mention the feedback the coming out from that defusal blade as well, but the bottom lane has started to push in. Appa is thinking of going in there, but he's actually poofed his primary meepo back in the fight along with his allies. They're chipping away on the tier 3, just using that Aegis as a buffer of sorts to get some damage done.
So the smarter thing for Appa to do, right? Okay. Yeah. He's... Oh, what? Invincible got one of them! The Deafening Blast upon Appa. Appa being controlled with the Cold Snap. SSK joins the fray, Arcane Curse. Pakimono goes in. The Boulder Smash whiffed because of the Tornado, but they've got the Meteor, they'll get the kill.
Okay. I mean, Ucypher brings out the best and the worst in people. SSK, whose native language isn't even Hindi, is now shouting abuses in Hindi on the stage.
No, it's not SSK.
It's SSK as well. I saw him shouting alongside.
I'm just bloody confused.
Okay then. They're fighting their way back into this game, both in the game and outside of it.
SSK's Hindi is quite fluid, man. Anyway, Darshan's picked up the Axe Scepter. So that's Stampy that lets you move across slopes. And it's also a lot of damage reduction coming in thanks to that Acceptor. So it's really going to help them out. Especially himself when he ends up taking an Omni Slash.
This game, it's actually comic relief at this point because the victor will only be determined by which team throws less. Yeah, it's not about skill, it's not really about luck, it's not about decision making. It's just about which team decides not to throw today.
Yeah, getting the D-Wart, so there's no sentry just outside the base to deal with Remstar if he gets away.
Still an Aegis on him.
Remstar low on mana, Dashin getting closer and closer to that heart. He's also taking that 15% damage return talent. There's the tornado EMP. It's right upon Akrid. Akrid might have to four staff away, but the EMP did connect.
That tier 3 is falling,
oh, but
here
they've got Dashin, the four staff, just in the nick of time. The kinetic field a second too late.
This Remstar is actually go mana, time. I mean, you still go for this because Remstar still got himself the Aegis. I would not be happy if they chose to run away.
I think you go.
They're bailing.
They're bailing. This, no, what? They go. Invincible canceled his own BOT. Now, if Apple just TP's bot, gives a little bit of momentum to the bottom lane and heads for the rack stop, they're in a bit of a pickle because the Invoker can't come back to defend. Instead, the Yakshas have popped to smoke themselves.
What is this absurd indecision coming out from Crusaders? At one point, he wants to go back. Then he says, no, I'll stay. But now he realizes staying doesn't do anything. So he's backing away again. The Aegis got taken away from Remstar while they were dilly-dallying about this.
What were Yakshas thinking, in my opinion? I don't know. They smoked and they moved towards the bottom lane. Now they're hanging about mid. They aren't going top. They aren't going mid. They aren't going bottom. They're going back to their tier threes. This is equally comical. Both teams have a sense of humor indeed. Dashin just goes back to pushing out the top lane and Invincible finally BOT's bot. SSK is in base. I mean, right now pressing that one button is more crucial than everything else. But he does deal a fair amount of damage with all that intelligence he's stolen.
What's the next progression here for Appa? He's finished up the Silver Edge over and above the Scythe as well as the Eth Blade.
The next progression for everyone is just Roshan.
It's always Roshan for everyone here. Refresh Roshan on either the Disruptor or the Lich would be nice on the side of Yakshas. Meanwhile, I think it's fairly obvious you give it over to the Silencer on the side of Crusaders.
You think you give the Refresh Roshan to the Juggernaut?
Maybe actually. That's not a bad suggestion at all. But I feel like a Disruptor with double Static Storm would be a lot more impactful in the fights.
Yeah. He's got to land both of them, though.
True. Yakshas, they're going to go for Shrines instead.
Okay. So the Yakshas are going to push with a 2000 net worth advantage.
No, they're not. They're just going to take Shrines and then go back and wait for Roshan to respawn.
So, I'm pretty confident that if I just leave my camera at the next Rosh pit for the next 3 minutes, I'm not going to miss anything.
VP, he picked up a blink dagger of his own, so if they do pick up the refresher shard, it might actually be ideal for him to hold on to it. Roshan will know how long he respawns in just a minute. Appa is just gonna leave his primary meepo in the pit while the entirety of Crusaders will just sit in their home.
Yeah, SSK's picked up a smoke, so if he senses that they're missing for too long, he's gonna pop a smoke. You got this observer ward coming up from the dais, scouting out movements through this part of the terrain. No vision other than the Sunstrike and the Fort Spirits to scout the pit for the Crusaders. Both teams, they're in a stalemate.
Well, Invincible has an observer ward towards the bottom river. I think a slightly decent play would be to just BOT bottom, give a couple of waves momentum and then come running back. By just sitting in the base, he's wasting a lot of farm time, valuable farm time that could have been used. While Akrid continues to get larger, so too does the Meepo. Juggernaut's not stopped his progression either. Look at Akrid, man. He's got Ascari and he's queued up a butterfly with 5.3k gold in his bank account. He could pick up the Eagle Song right away and still have money for the buyback. I don't think he should be going into the push without picking up his next item. That's a waste of all the time you spent farming.
I left my mouse in the rush pit.
You might want to pan back though.
Okay, they managed to catch Akrid here. Now, they commit the Stampede. You got the Meteor. It's a bit of a white ball. Omni Slash upon Invincible. The BKB is not going to save you there. The Static Storm whiffed. And what's going on? Dashin all by himself. Well, he's got the Lotus Orb. He's got the Gains Return Damage Talent. And there's a decent Magnetize. It's pushing some of the Yakshas back. They're still not able to bring down Dashin, but with this glimpse, with this Chain Frost, hopefully they can. Tornado manages to clip both of them. The Cataclysm not perfectly timed. It's not going to connect on anyone, but Remstar runs through. He focuses VP and brings him down. He could turn his attention towards Akrid. Meanwhile, Appa just doing his thing. He's eliminated the Invoker. He's focusing Bakemono. Remstar on a wild goose chase himself, just ditches his team, and SSK, it's his turn to team up with Invincible, who's bought back to try and kill bring down Appa. Finally, he will. Kalnag jumps in. They want to bring down this Invoker, but they just can't. Invincible turns right back with the tornado, and Remstar's rejoining his team. They've brought down Akrid.
I'm speechless, man. Everyone is just going ham on the stage. This is like City Light Market on a Friday morning. All the aunties have come to buy fish and they've ended up playing Ucypher. SSK just standing back, right-clicking away, gets all the stolen intelligence from that fight. It's a full five-man wipe. It did cost them a buyback on the
Invincible.
Invoker, so that, and the Silencer for that matter, but it's still worth it. It's well worth it for Crusaders. That was such a horrible fight from the Yakshas. They were just all over the place. There were four heroes dealing with one centaur on the back lines, while VP said, "I'm Shaktiman," and runs forward and throws down a circle of fire or a circle of blue fire on the floor. Meanwhile...
Yeah, SSK bumps into VP. I mean, it's rather clear. Oh, SSK going for the solo kill. The last word upon him. But VP, quick with the blink, just gets the hell out of there. They're moving towards Roshan. This dire observer has scouted that out. Yep, they didn't bother de-warding it in... they're going to get Aegis and Cheese. Now, the problem is that a bunch of the Yakshas are respawning in a bit. Can they make it to the pit quick enough? I don't think so. Who gets a refresher shard? Darshan? Or SSK? I don't know.
I think it's... You give it over to Darshan. Not Darshan, actually. SSK.
Stampede, reduced damage. It's...
Silencer. Double global silence, man.
Okay.
I don't even think it's a contest.
Okay.
But never mind. It looks like they're going to give it over to the Centaur. Well, VP is trying to split push now because he has nothing better to do. Crusaders. They look like a broken team, but apparently getting shouted at on stage has lit a new fire under them.
Yeah.
But of course they're not going to push.
This
game won't end until another five Roshans have died, right?
Yeah. Well, Invincible did manage to just deal with VP's so-called split push, and now the Crusaders are moving towards the top lane, where Appa, has finally TP'd out.
Yeah, very casual smoke being popped there again. They'll find nothing on the back of this. It's it's like standard protocol here at Ucypher that when one team has the Aegis, the other team cannot leave their base. Yeah. They just sit in their base and do nothing. And then the team that has the Aegis will also do nothing because they can't see anyone on the map.
Yeah. And then they smoke when they don't see anyone
on
the
map. For lack of a better word, it's noob.
Gentleman's agreement. Darshan got the Axe, sitting on a lot of gold. Not too much, really. But he's going to get his heart soon enough. He's just going to pound away under Tier 3. Tier 3 just falls to the return damage, courtesy the Centaur. Kalnag going in, swarm upon him. Might have to deal with the bug first. Remstar focusing the barracks. Look for the initiation. Darshan goes in right upon Kalnayak. The Earthbind upon Remstar forcing out a BKB. Akrid trying to man up. Darshan pops the Stampede. A quick Hurricane Pike splits them into two and ensures that Darshan won't get caught in the Static Storm. Darshan once again attracting all of the Yakshas to deal with him.
Where's he just Appa? Doesn't care, man.
Appa has not yet come in. Darshan tanking it up. You got a Tornado. Tornado just splits them into two. The melee barracks still stand. They could go once more.
That is the first tier 3 tower that they take down though. Crusaders have finally opened up their path into the base and they've taken it on the exact same lane where they lost their own tower. Yep. They'll go back, they'll take a shrine. It's the shrine near the Rosh pits. If at all they want to go back for a Roshan later on, they could.
If at all.
Well, when they go for the next Roshan, yeah. I think I ought to rephrase that. But they still have the global silence with a refresher shard on SSK. I feel like they should be utilizing that. Darshan needs to go in and look for another initiation.
Did Darshan use the refresher shard?
No, he gave it over to SSK.
Oh, okay.
Remstar basically prematurely used that BKB.
Yeah, that I don't know what that was.
And I think that's why they've decided to step back a bit and come back once it cools down. But it's back again and not too much love has been lost.
Darshan, Lotus Orb upon him.
At this point, Darshan is to Yakshas what Akrid is to the Crusaders.
Yeah.
It's just that piece of meat that goes and stands on the front lines.
Remstar scurrying up the high ground, tagged with the Thunderstrike, could get glimpsed if he's not careful. He doesn't have a link in sphere, might have to pop his BKB once more. VP undercover the Glimmer Cape, looking for that Static Storm. He's got it up and going. Darshan just manning up. Akrid trying to do the same for his side. He's dealing with the creep wave, and somehow in the midst of this all, Remstar bought his own HP down to half. Akrid just pushing back, dashing glimpse back. There's the static storm. Immediate stone gaze, but the tornado and EMP to follow that up. Akrid pops his BKB while Dashin moves on a VP in a corner of the map. The boulder smash clips Kalyak. The geomagnetic crib does nothing. The chain frost bounces onto Dashin. Dashin's got to be careful. Bakemono's been brought down.
What on earth is going on?
Bakemono was the one screaming away at the Yakshas. And the Yakshas said it's only fair that we scream right back at them.
What on earth were the Yakshas?
Got Remstar with a glimpse. Remstar pops his BKB. And they got detection. Appa a little bit too slow with the Hex. He could go in. He could blink forward. He pops the Shadow Blade. He's hunting for Remstar. Remstar doesn't know this. He's moved into the trees and Appa is there as well. This is awkward. It's a lot of strange things happen in the fog and in the night. But nobody's going to catch anyone just yet. VP's still hunting. Now they could throw the scan and they
would see him.
They've caught Remstar. Have they got detection? No, they haven't.
They think he's in the circle, but he's gone back up top.
Remstar just panics and pops the cheese. He's had enough.
Talk about space creation, man. But that's about to end. Appa, what?
Okay. Appa knew what he was doing.
That took way longer than necessary, but they get the kill nonetheless. But it's a little inconsequential because he has the buyback. I wish I knew what was going on.
You know, back home we get shouted for playing video games by our parents, and we play video games and shout at each other. What? What's the point?
This is the PTSD they brought from home onto the main stage.
Yeah, exactly. Everybody's become their own mother and father just shouting at each other here. Dashin's gone in. There should be a debt on VP. The boulder smash mistimed. The meteor sort of mistimed as well. But VP is going to die. Dashin with the blade mail, soaking up the damage in the static storm and dealing it out as well. They pop the stampede. This is Dashin's retreat. Akrid with his BKB, focusing the fourth spirits, not the barracks. They've still got the glyph. They're not popping it. The barracks will fall. The mini barracks have fallen. Bakemono's got to catch them, for he has to shout at them once more. But, well, Remstar buys back. And what is this?
He bought back so late. I mean,
they've caught Kalyak with the tornado. But okay, so Remstar bought back late, somewhere just before his barracks fell, right?
Yeah, it was when Medusa popped the BKB and started right clicking, that's when he bought back. Not like he was going to get much accomplished after.
He didn't get much accomplished.
Meepo, he's gone ahead and finished up the Skadi as well, so he's a significantly... he's got a significantly larger HP pool now.
So they had the glyph, but they didn't pop it.
Did they?
Yeah, they had the glyph.
No, they didn't.
Oh, they... okay. Did they use the glyph then?
They had the global silence, which they could have used to take a fight, but they were hesitating about whether or not they should have taken a four-man fight there with Remstar. Not sure if he should have bought back or not. But now the barracks have been opened up. Top lane will continuously push in for the Dire. Well, Khalnaya.
Okay, so this smoke and this scan has given them a little bit of information. VP is steeping, but Dashin is waiting. They're going to start screaming in 3, 2.
Nah, that was too easy and inconsequential.
Nobody hates VP.
Okay then, the second shrine taken apart and we're looking at Crusaders hopefully looking to try and take a lane of barracks themselves. Nope, Roshan's still down for at least a minute now.
Yeah, but they're not going to get anything done till then.
Remstar's also going for a BKB, a butterfly instead of picking up an MKB.
Mm-hmm. Akrid has his own butterfly. I don't know. Dashin wants to go in. Oh, AoE Deafening Blast.
Casual AoE Deafening Blast.
I don't know what that was. I have no idea what that was.
Did he invoke the wrong spell by any chance? I mean, that looked like he was aiming for a tornado instead.
I don't know. But he didn't take the 18-second tornado cooldown, which...
No, I think it's alright. I mean, versus the Meepo, you won't have the AoE Deafening Blast.
Okay.
Akrid marching forward through the middle lane. Now this is just turning into a push you pull me sort of game. Mm-hmm. One team pushes, the other team looks at them, they run away. The other team pushes, the other team looks at them, they run away.
Yeah. Then they all run to Roshan.
Khalnayak, Punk, Akrid sticking about in the middle lane. Their allies are joining them as well. VP. He's got an Aghanim Scepter queued up, but that's a bit ambitious considering he needs to hold on to the buyback money as well. Darshan, I just don't know how they deal with him anymore. Not only does he have that heart, he's also picked up a blade mail next.
Yeah.
He's got 4.6k HP, 19 armor.
If he...
What the hell is this? How do you kill Darshan anymore? Akimono, does he want to initiate this fight? Darshan's going to be the one running on the front lines. While Akrid... Oh, the Aghanim!
That is just broken. Akrid sent into base, forced to pop his BKB, forced to pop the Stone Gaze, while Kanaik just starts pounding away on the tier 3. They're taking down this tier 3, they need to get something done. Boulder smash up on Kalnag. There's the AoE Deafening Blast, there's the Static Storm, which much like its past 3 attempts have done nothing in team fight.
I actually think Bakemono might have Boulder smashed him out of the way of that Static Storm. I'm not sure if it was his own Hurricane Pike or if the Boulder smash was misplaced, but Akrid got away really quickly from there.
Oh, they're going in for Akrid. Tornado, EMP, and the Boulder smash once again missed time. Darshan goes in with the Hoof Stomp, he's had enough.
Where's the
his
team,
tier 3 has been brought down. They need to follow up. Darshan's getting glimpsed. This is when you want to go in. Bakemono still looking for that perfect magnetize.
Top lane as well. Massive creep wave enters the base with double siege wagons and a whole bunch of range creeps. That range barrack looks like it's going to go down. Where the hell is the team? Why aren't they pushing when there's a massive wave approaching from the top side as well?
I don't know. Appa is just going back to Roshan. Okay. This is where the game's going to end because, I mean...
No, I wouldn't count my chickens before they hatch.
Yeah, they're going to contest. Somebody's going to win or lose a fight and hope maybe the game just ends.
Darshan has an ambitious Radiance queued up as well, by the way. So if they ignore him in the next few fights after his Radiance is online, he's going to be burning them as well.
I don't think we're going to have too many fights. This time Kalnag has the Refresher Shard. So double Omni Slash.
I don't know. I'm not sold by it. I still don't think they have enough. I'm actually surprised that Akrid kept the cheese instead of the Aegis and Kalnayak, and Meepo's...
Appa has the Aegis.
Actually, yeah, I guess Meepo holding the Aegis is obviously better. High ground attempt, number 9999, gonna be thwarted by
Bakemono
two false spirits.
Can Bakemono kick Akrid in again? Now, Akrid has the BKB. What was that glow? No, thank God.
I think you try and kick one of the lesser folks in, like the Lich or maybe even the Disruptor for that matter. You don't go for... Yeah, there we go. He's going to go for the Disruptor. He gets the Boulder Smash behind, rolling Boulders in as well. They've isolated VP, who ends up going down. And you know what happens when it's a 4-1-5 fight. Kalnayak spins to win and runs to the fountain.
Yep.
Top. The range barracks still stand. Fallen Spirits will deal with those creeps coming in. And now it's another 55 minute wait at best before the Yakshas think about pushing again.
Darshan's getting closer and closer to his Radiance. I guess he hands over the gem to someone else and puts in the Radiance. taking a look at buyback, everybody's got it.
So this game, you know, I think we should start having predictions on how long games are going to last as opposed to who's going to win these games.
My bet is another 10 minutes.
So that's essentially saying another Roshan? But then in 10 minutes, if another Roshan comes online, that means we're looking at another 10 minutes. But then you're going to have another Roshan. So this game is never ending in conclusion. I think we're gonna see another backdoor game here, backdoor base race kind of game, a la Sherdils and that Juggernaut.
But Appa has been rather quiet. I mean, he could be attempting to do such things. Maybe even finding solo pickoffs himself. Since he's the one holding onto the edges, he should be the one taking risks. Anyway, they're grouped up as five once more. The Crusaders did have a man advantage, but they spent it dealing with the top lane and that too not very well.
Meanwhile,
the top
lane's
pushing in
here.
Once more.
Appa's on the bottom side with his Aegis.
Yeah. I'm gonna assume that he tries and loops around. Bakemono, how does he play this one? Who's he gonna kick in this time around?
I think it's still the Disruptor that's the prime target for him.
Well, they've got Acrid. This should be a guaranteed EMP. Now, Remstar could have tried to pop his linkage, but they go in on Dash and they glimpse him back. The Stampede, though, more than enough. The Global Silence still available. Appa still doing his thing, pushing it through the bot lane. Bakemono being focused. The Swarm, along with, pretty much nothing, ensures that the melee barracks, the range barracks fall. Darshan goes in, they've got the meatball and the AoE deafening blast. Kalnag drops low, drops the healing ward. Acrid has had enough. He's focusing the barracks. Invincible pops his BKB. He's trying to deal with Kalnag. Now, this is Kalnag with a refresher shot. So, Omni Slash upon Darshan, which does a whole bit, and Darshan pushes the back up. They're really happy because they're trying to bring down Appa. Now, Appa has agents. He's really bought down the melee barracks. And the four of them are all caught in the kinetic field. There's the Global Silence finally. They're just going to turn towards buildings. And it has finally hit them that if you hit buildings, you can win the game. Acrid is, well, he's low on mana. I think he's got the cheese.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, this
Punk is just says, Chodo, we'll go have a cup of tea outside and come back.
Anyway, used upon Darshan. He's trying to find some response to this. He has bought back, if I'm not mistaken. Remstar pops his BKB. The only one he can kill is his former teammate, Punk. But even that's not a kill.
Oh, VP just gave up at this point.
VP is just drawing Rangoli at this point with that Static Storm. Acrid, he's in a bit of a pickle. He has got the cheese. No, he doesn't. He's got his BKB. They finally lose VP. That's two meteors from Invincible. And Acrid also goes down.
But they have the buybacks. And it's Mega Creeps versus now, Crusaders.
So, for those of you who are new to Ucypher, you play the game. You take Roshan six times, you take three lanes of barracks, and then after that, it's about just staying in the game so that you can probably get the opportunity to shout back at your opponents once more.
I don't even know what's going on anymore. This game has gone on for 62 minutes. It looked like Crusaders should have won the early game, but Yakshas ended up winning the early game. The mid game was supposed to be for Yakshas, Crusaders won that. And now the late game, finally there's some level of normalcy being restored with Yakshas coming out strong. I say strong, but that's a very relative term because Crusaders are just beelining down the middle lane, going for the jugular, going for the Hail Mary play.
That's
here.
Okay. This is acceptable.
This is acceptable, honestly.
I mean, they aren't covering in their base and dealing with Mega Creeps. I mean, they're fighting.
Someone has to go back, though.
This isn't bragging rights anymore.
Darshan's going to go back. He's going to deal with one or two waves
of
Mega
Creeps. Has he got
BOTs? Yeah, Appa just says, all right, you guys come mid. I'll go make a football field out of your base instead.
Okay. Appa's gone in. There's a gem on the floor. Contemplating life next to the gem, and he's waiting for someone to show. It's Darshan. You think Meepo can kill Darshan for now?
So, oh no, okay. Wait a minute. Alright, he's got Boots of Travel, so he can get back to the base in a moment's notice. I was a little worried that Appa didn't have a way back to
the
base.
So, Remstar is kind of focusing barracks and focusing Kalnag as well. Kalnag drops the healing ward, he's low on mana. Kalnag used the refresher shot somewhere in the midst of that. Didn't quite catch it. Kalnag goes in. What? Turn. Kill it. Kill that juggernaut. Now's your turn. They kill the healing ward instead.
Tier 4s are falling and Darshan is desperately trying to steal with
Boulder
them.
Boulder smash up on Kalnag. They could go in. VP once again.
Drawing Rangoli.
Now they could cancel SSK's TP. They're not going to. Appa, he's been shifting between lanes. He's had enough. He's popped his Silver Edge. He's hoping to catch someone. Bakemono too far out. And... Yeah.
Well, Appa.
Darshan's got the Radiance. I don't know.
What does Appa have right now? He's not gone for any further items. He's just holding on to buyback money. But he doesn't have a buyback for 5 more
what
minutes.
What do you go? Moonshard, AC?
I mean, I'd probably expect him to get rid
what
of that
What is
Silver
SSK
edge.
Doing? Stampede, Hextop. He could move over the high ground and he's going to do just that. A little pug, piggy scurries away there. Okay, they're yeah, it's going to culminate in one last round of shouting here.
So Akrid's got that split shot, uses modifier talent. So
that's going to be nice. Darshan goes in, double edge on the creep wave. Now they could roll in and try and kick Akrid towards the fountain. Akrid just turns right back, pounds away on Darshan. That return damage means nothing. Akrid strong and then not too perturbed by this centaur. Tornado EMP, the stone gate's not doing too much. Darshan shows his back. Acrid pounding away. VP, the kinetic field is going to connect. The static storm is there. They're going to focus barracks. They're going to start screaming. Geomagnetic clip, AoE deafening blast, boulder smash upon Kalnag. No one falls just yet. Kalnag being controlled. Pops his Mantra Style, pops his Blade Fury, but goes down.
He's dead. No buyback.
Appa, what's the plan here? Oh, They've turned one into stone. It's their old friend VP, who they'll leave for the silence as well as the center, while Remstar moves on to the Lich. That's a defense. Now, Appa's coming in. Appa never participated in that fight. Neither did he split push very well.
What the hell was he doing, honestly?
So, I want to take a look at the network graph.
Why? It doesn't even matter at this point. There's a football field in the Radiant base.
I mean, there's one tier 4 still standing.
They don't have a buyback on the Juggernaut. If they know this, they might want to consider that Hail Mary play once again.
Yakshas dugout ready to jump onto
the Yakshas dugout has been standing for the last 15 minutes, but... Yeah. I mean, are they new to Ucypher by any chance? Do they not know what happens after Mega Creeps?
Roshan. And that's where Appa heads.
Everyone's a Hrithik Roshan fan here at Ucypher. Bakemono.
Dashin's also taken the game.
What's he been doing? Bakemono's. I mean, Bakemono's just been jumping about for the most part, smacking boulder smash after boulder smash. But on more than one occasion, I've seen his stone going under the heroes with a tornado lift coming out from
Invincible. Yeah, time and time again, it's happened at least thrice. I've noticed that happen at least thrice. Invincible as well as Bakemono are releasing their tornado as well as the boulder smash at the exact same time.
Meanwhile, SSK is just stacking the intelligence, man. He's at 50 stolen intelligence with his own refresher orb sitting in his stash.
Yeah.
Medusa, she's basically maxed out. I mean, perhaps you get rid of the...
Manta?
No, I'd
the Hurricane Pike?
Probably say you get rid of the Hurricane Pike and get a damage item at this point.
Because okay.
Akrid's hitting fast and he's annoying them with the Skadi slow, but he's not really hurting them.
You think MKB?
MKB would be nice. Or a Divine Rapier if he's feeling cocky.
Nah, you go Roshan. There's already Courier sitting there.
Who the hell keeps the Aegis though now? Meepo again for the Silver Edge.
SSK with the champ. I mean, the Crusaders are not giving up. They're fighting.
VP. He's picked up a Yules next year. He gave up on the Raghunam Scepter dream a while ago.
Yeah. With the Yules, he's gonna stay alive. I can't dispel the Yules anymore with the Diffusal Blade. Gonna buy him some time versus Remstar, and if he comes down and drops the Static Storm straight on top of Remstar, could be crucial if Remstar is not holding on to a available BKB.
Darshan with the Radiance Burn now. He can no longer be ignored in the battle as well. No one on the side of Yakshas knows what they're doing, man. They're just hoping that this next Aegis will help them get something done.
I think they all know what they're doing. I beg to differ. They're just gonna wait for Roshan number
9,000.
Five.
Okay, Rosh is gonna drop. Appa's not TPing in. Does he not want the Aegis? There's also a DD rune. This is big.
Trying to control his slot.
Sunstrike did spot out this attempt, but what are they gonna do really? They can't get to the pit in time. Appa, I mean, he could even pick up a Moonshot if he didn't want to buy any new items for that Silver Edge. He's holding on to about 7.8k gold. Some progression is better than no progression. Might as well go pick it up. There it is though. Akrid gonna hold on to the Aegis instead of the Boots of Travel. He's just gonna go and right click buildings by the looks of it.
Yeah, he's probably gonna go. Die, respawn, die again, buyback, BOT.
He's also got a cheese, so killing him thrice.
Four times. I don't know. Stupid. I've lost count. And they have one tier 4 to work with. Bakemono's pretty much got a kick, Akrid into base. Darshan's gone in, just man fighting Akrid. There's a Static Storm on the floor. They're holding onto the global. They're focusing Darshan, who's looking for the Stampede.
Khalnak
jumps in with the Omni Slash, and Darshan eliminated. Immediate buyback. Remstar takes a couple of slashes. Khalnak has the refresher shot, so he could go again. The Cataclysm doesn't really connect on anyone. Bakemono turns VP to stone and kicks him right back. Now, VP's committed his Static Storm, so kill on him isn't too much, but Remstar hurting where it really counts. He's chasing Khalnak down. Elsewhere, they do manage to bring VP, but here comes Appa. He's finally decided to participate in the fight, but that wasn't the most impactful of initiations. Akrid being focused, he's got Aegis, Earthblade keeping him alive, Tornado gonna whiff. Akrid gonna turn around. Darshan with the return damage, with the blade mail, takes away the first life of the Medusa. He's preparing for round two. Akrit pops his BKB. He's focusing Darshan. Darshan doesn't have the Stampede, and Akrit thinks that he can bring him down. Kalnag gotta respect that return damage. Darshan dropping really low. This could be a dieback. The Geomagnetic Grip buying them some time. They're still holding on. Appa still waiting on the sidelines.
Crusaders have lost their tier 4 tower, but they still have a global silence to work with. If at all they decide to get aggressive on the side of Yakshas, they can pop a global
and turn it. It is 4v5. Now, this is... I don't know.
So they stalled an Aegis refresher cheese push right now. What do you do when you lose
the
your Aegis?
Did I pop the cheese? Oh, yeah. What? I want to say the reason that the Yakshas are struggling to close this is because Appa is not participating anymore in these teams.
I don't know where the hell he's been, man. I think they're trying to let him go in and rat the tier 4 and the throne, but it's clearly not working out.
It could work after the next Roshan.
Don't make me hate you, Vivek.
I hate myself at this point.
What is even happening here?
I don't think they know either.
71 minutes in.
I said, okay, so my bet was in the next 10 minutes and my prediction came in at the 59 minute mark, so I've lost my bet.
I think we need Divine Rapiers at this point. Akrit needs to pick up a Divine Rapier on the side of...
But no, come on, you're going to hold on to buyback forever. Okay, both teams pop a smoke. This is where it gets interesting. No one has Aegis. The Crusaders are working with a naked throne. Appa, he's not been doing too much.
VP got his Ags, by the way.
Okay, VP's picked up his Ags. Now... VP's got to be a little patient. But the high ground in favor of the Crusaders. They do have that Observer Ward. Do they want to go in? Bakimono, come on, make a play. Just go in. Okay, they don't have vision of them because they were spoke for themselves. My bad. They're just going to walk into the base. This is it. VP goes in. The Static Storm whiffed. The Boneless Smash, the Geomagnetic Grip, the Global Silence, everything Sadashin can get away. The Cataclysm committed, they're all almost connecting to that Sunstrike. And here goes Invincible, he drops the Meteor. They manage to bring down Appa while Akrit, he's pounding away on SSK. And SSK is still alive. They control the Medusa. Medusa needs to focus the throne and she's going to do just that. But Remstar's on the side. He's focusing the Medusa, but Kalnag, he's bought back. I think Appa's bought back as well. It's done. They've said it. Bakimono goes in. There's the Magnetize. But without the Centaur, they just can't defend.
I mean, that could have been done at least 15 minutes ago. All they had to do was run in the building and right-click it with all the heroes. Instead, it took them a buyback from the Meepo.
What?